People tell me I'm slow. Yeah, well, you're slow. Everybody's slow. We're all slow. Hooray! Hi, Slowpokes. Julian here for DNews. If you've ever raced a cheetah and you're not named Usain Bolt, you probably lost. Or heck, even if you tried racing against your cat, I bet you still lost. From horses to dogs to birds, it seems the entire animal kingdom is faster and stronger than we are. Why? Well, we evolved to fit into our ecological niche, but even compared to our nearest relatives, the chimpanzee and bonobos, we are considerably weaker. We weren't always this way. According to Dan Lieberman, a biological anthropologist at Harvard University, our chimp-like ancestor was a power athlete that was much stronger and faster than humans, but they had no endurance. So we traded our brawn for bigger brains and the ability to outrun our prey in a long-distance hunt. When our ancestors evolved from being mostly tree dwellers to savanna walkers, they probably traded strength and speed for endurance. This is creatively called the endurance hypothesis. Some researchers believe that humans evolved a unique predatory style. Rather than a fast and furious chase like a cheetah or Vin Diesel, humans take the slow and steady, wear down your prey till it collapses from exhaustion kind of action. And this takes very specific types of muscles. By comparison, cheetahs have muscles that are tailored to react quickly so they can reach top speeds of around 70 miles per hour. But the trade-off is they get exhausted quickly. They have no endurance. While we can never run that fast, we can run for a long time, maybe longer than any other animal. Sure, less exciting than a high-speed chase, but incredibly effective. But you're also slow because you're weak. Don't feel bad, we all are, comparatively speaking. One of our closest relatives, the chimpanzee, is about twice as strong as a human. Because they're arboreal, they spend most of their time in trees. Most of their strength is concentrated in their arms. Our ancestors probably had similar muscle strength to a chimpanzee around 6 million years ago, according to a study published in PLOS ONE. The researchers found that in the few million years since, human beings evolved dramatically. Our brains got bigger, specifically in our prefrontal cortex, the part that deals with long-term goal planning. They found that the prefrontal cortex was radically different in humans than from in chimpanzees, monkeys, and mice. It seemed to have evolved 4 times faster than the other parts of the body. And this is because, in part, humans started to evolve social structures that allowed us to, say, work together as a team to take down bigger prey. But there is a downside to a bigger brain. A bigger brain consumes more energy. Our brains consume 20% of the energy we use, which is a lot compared to other animals. So, where did the energy come from? Maybe from our muscles. The researchers also found our ancestors' muscles changed rapidly too, very rapidly, about 8 times faster than the rest of our body. So researchers believe that to deal with the energy demands of a bigger brain, our ancestors evolved smaller muscles to compensate. But more research is needed. Now, you may think this contradicts the Darwinian principle of survival of the fittest, but fit in this context doesn't mean physical fitness. It means an organism fits in a niche long enough to reproduce, so the genetic lineage survives. And it's not that being a smart wimp is always better than being a big dumb ox or vice versa. It's a matter of what's most beneficial for an organism based on its environment and competition. If coming down from the trees and learning to make fire means one day your offspring will populate the globe, it's probably worth giving up looking like a species of Mr. Universes. That's evolution. So you can't outrun a cheetah, but you can definitely outwalk it. Julia covers the endurance hypothesis in more detail right here.
So what's the evidence for this hypothesis? Well, one is the way we sweat. We evolved to chase our food in a really hot climate. Most animals release excess body heat by panting. While this might help your dog cool down on a hot summer day, panting actually gets in the way of breathing.
If you had the option to be ripped but also couldn't form basic sentences, would you take it? Mash your keyboard down in the comments, subscribe for more, and I will see you next time on DNews.